Hi all. In this session, I'm going to explain about how to get a pre-international certification course through Udemy. The course name is Formal Language and Automata Theory. So first, whatever the enrollment link is given here, I'm copying this link. Then you can open any browser. So here I opened Google Chrome. Simply you can copy the link. Then enter. So then whenever you can use this link, here it is showing free. So without that link, you won't get freely. So through this shareable link only, you will get free. So now here what you have to do, you have to click on enroll. So here you can use Google account. So that is very simple. So you can use Google account. So here, continue with Google. Now you can enter your Gmail ID, whatever the Gmail ID you are having. So suppose here I am using one of the email. You can enter same password using for Gmail. So whenever you are logging through your Gmail ID first time to Udemy, it will ask to sign up. In sign up, simply you have to enter your name, whatever the email ID you are linking, then password. So you can choose your Gmail password or new password also, no problem. So after that, now here you can see, it is showing the summary, original price $1,280, coupon discount minus $1,280, so total zero. Now click on enroll. Now we can see, now you are entered into the course space. So the course title is showing Formal Language and Automata Theory. So your progress initially it is empty. So how to complete this course? Within just 2 to 3 minutes time to get certificate. Later you can learn at any time. So once you enroll, this will be available throughout lifetime in your account, whatever the email ID you used. So now immediately I want to get certificate, suppose. So now here you can click on start the course. So then here you can see, it is showing the description about the course. So here one practice test is also there. So 30 questions are there, total 52 lectures with 1.5 total hours duration. So get Udemy certificate by completing this course. So after my demonstration, if you can follow the same steps, then here you will get your certificate. So now what you have to do? So here my tips are only for getting the certificate. So not for full-fledged learning. So full-fledged learning, you can go through later. So lecture to lecture. So now here you can see, in the right side, course content menu is there. So if you can close this one. So here, if you can play the videos lecture wise, so you will listen all the videos. So now, if you want to skip also, you can move to the next right side button. Then it shows next video like that. So now, but I want to get the certificate. What you have to do here, see in the course content section wise, here you can see total you are having 15 sections. So total 15 sections are there. So each section consisting of some lectures. The lecture numbers also there. So what you have to do here, simply you have to click on all the lectures for each and every section. You can make tick mark. See, whenever you are making tick mark, here you can observe your progress. Your progress, this icon initially showing gray color. Now, whenever you are clicking a particular lecture by tick mark, see, it is changing gray color to green color. So now here, now first section, all are marked. Then coming to second section, so again here see I am making tick mark. Now here you can see, so the green color is adding to that progress icon. Now here you can see again like that. Now I will make all modules lectures as tick mark. So now like that all lectures you have to make tick mark. Now you can observe the green color is adding to that progress icon. Okay, now after making all modules tick marks, then finally what you have to do, so total you are having 15 plus sections, so all you can make tick mark. After making all sections as tick mark, then finally you are having one practice test. So that practice test you need to attempt. Here now here you can see almost 99% is over. So now you need to attempt practice test. So click on practice test. So now click on under this test one. So then you can move up. Here test instructions are there. 30 questions with 1 hour duration. 40% is required to pass. So even by randomly putting some answers also, even if you can fail, you will get certificate. But later also, you can practice this test any number of times. So that's why here no restrictions are there. Now I'm starting the test. So now here see, here I will provide a key also. So the question one, Hooke's theorem condition is, so the condition is P equal to NP. So then Turing machine operates over, so the answer is infinite memory tape. Then given grammar S derives A derives A derives null, B derives B. Which among the following productions are useless productions? But directly I am providing key, I am not giving explanation. Anyway, after learning this full course, you will get idea. So now here, for identifying useless productions, that means whichever the variable that is not derived from starting variable S. Now see, from starting variable capital A is derived, but B is not derived. Therefore, B is useless production. Then coming to next question, A derives X, B Z, and B derives Y. Then the simplified grammar would be, that means always you can take the starting variable production in that right hand side, any variable, if it contains a production, you can substitute. Then that is called as a derivation. Now here, A derives X, B, Z. Now B contains the production as Y. Now in place of B in A production, you can substitute it as Y. Now A derives X, Y, Z. Now see, this is the answer. Then coming to next question, every NFA, there is an equivalent DFA. Yes, this is true. Then coming to next question, Turing machine can be represented using the following tools. So here, Q and input tape, transition table, transition graph. So all are used to represent Turing machine. Then DFA computational power is less than, as per Chomsky hierarchy, DFA computational power is less than NFA, Turing machine, PDA. That means all. Comparing to non-deterministic finite automata, Turing machine, pushdown automata, DFA computational power is less than of all these. Then coming to next question, in NFA transition function is mapping from NFA non-deterministic finite automata. So delta is mapping from Q cross sigma to 2 power Q. So first one is the correct one. Then next question, if A equal to 0 comma 1, so is an alphabet with digits 0, 1, then A closure. Here, this is star closure, which includes null also. So this can be expanded. So first you can take null, then 0 comma 1, then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So first with 0 length, that is null, then with 1 length, 0, 1, then with 2 length combination, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, then 3 length combination, and so on, you will get infinite. So here, asterisk means it includes null also. If it is positive closure, it won't include null. So the answer is this one, epsilon comma 0 comma 1 comma 0 0 comma and so on. Then coming to next question. From a state Q, all the states that are reachable with epsilon edges, that means in the transition diagram, the transition is labeled with epsilon, that means null. So then what we'll call it as, that is called as epsilon closure of that state Q. This is one function. This will be included in NFA with epsilon concept. So epsilon closure of Q. The next question, the use of variable dependency graph is in. So in context free grammar, simplification of CFG. So for removing useless variables or useless symbols, so we will use the dependency graph. So removal of useless variables. This is the answer. Then coming to next question, MPCP stands for, this is one of the undecidability problem. So PCP stands for post correspondence problem, whereas MPCP stands for modified PCP. So modified PCP is the correct answer. Then DFA can recognize, so deterministic finite automaton can recognize, which is type 3 as per Chomsky hierarchy. So type 3, it accepts only regular languages followed by regular grammar. So only regular grammars are accepted by the DFA. The next question, which among the following is the format of unit production? In context-free grammar, the general form of unit production is, so right-hand side, it contains a single variable. So then that production is said to be unit production. Here you can see the first one, right-hand side, it doesn't contain single variable. Then A derives small b. So this is a terminal in the right-hand side. The last one, A derives capital B, that is variable. So single variable is there. So this is the general form of unit production. Then next question, DAS has multiple transitions on a start state for the same input symbol. See, from same input symbol, from the start state, more than one transition is exist. Then that is called as non-deterministic finite automata. Then next question, Turing machine is more powerful than finite state machine. Because, so the reason is, it has no finite control. It has the capability to remember arbitrary long sequence of input symbols. Then tape movement is confined to one direction, which is the correct answer. So it has the capability to remember arbitrary long sequence of input symbols. Why? Because Turing machine takes infinite tape. So this is the correct answer. Then next question, PCP is, so just now we mentioned post correspondence problem, so which is undecidable problem. So therefore PCP is undecidable. Then next question, W equal to XYZ is the string, then prefixes are, how to find the prefixes? So starting with null, you can take the first symbol from the string, then two symbol combinations, then the complete string. So like all substrings, you can write including null. First null is there, then X is one substring, then XY, two consecutive characters, then the entire string itself. This is called as prefix. Therefore, epsilon comma X comma XY comma XYZ are the prefixes of the string W equal to XYZ. Next question, in Millet machine, lambda, which is called as output function, is mapping from. So here, by taking state with input, then it gives delta, that is output alphabet. So Q cross sigma to delta. So this is the mapping function of lambda in Millet machine. Then NFA has N states, then DFA has dash number of states. So 2n. Any non-deterministic finite automata, if it has N states, then equivalent to DFA consisting of 2n states. Then here one statement is given, instantaneous description can be designed for a Turing machine. State true or false? Yes, actually for Turing machine, by using instantaneous description only, the design can be done. Therefore, the answer is true. Then coming to next question, if L1 and L2 are recursively enumerable languages over S, then the following is or recursively enumerable. So now here you can see, there two languages are recursively enumerable over S. So now L2 intersection, actually this is L1. L1 intersection L2, then L1 union L2. That means recursively enumerable languages are closed under both union and intersection. Therefore, both answers are correct. So now both. So L1 intersection L2 and L1 union L2. The next question. A grammar is denoted by G and is defined as dash number of tuples. So any grammar, it may be a regular grammar or context-free grammar, any grammar in the automata theory, which is defined as with combination of four tuples, G equal to V, T, S, P. Therefore, four is the correct answer. So then which of the following is called Bahr-Hillel lemma? The first one, pumping lemma for regular language, pumping lemma for context-free languages, pumping lemma for context-sensitive languages. So for this, so the Bahr-Hillel lemma is the alternate name of pumping lemma for context-free languages. Therefore, this is the correct answer. So then coming to next question, if sigma is an alphabet, then L is a language over sigma, then the problem L is given a string W in sigma closure, decide whether or not W is in. So W is in L or not, the given language itself. So L is the correct answer. Then next question, in NFA with epsilon, so delta cap of Q comma W will be all states P such that one can go from Q to P along with a path labeled W, perhaps including edges labeled. So edges labeled with, so in this null is also allowed. So therefore labeled with epsilon. Then next question. A recursively enumerable language L can be recursive if, so every possible sequence of moves T, the Turing machine accepts L because it is halted. Then L dash is recursive enumerable. So both are correct answers. Then coming to next question. A string W is accepted by a non-deterministic finite automaton if delta cap of Q naught comma W equal to P for some P belongs to Q in the acceptance of either finite automata or NFA, any automata. So whatever the set of states we will get, in this at least one state belongs to a final state. Then only you can say the string or language is accepted. Therefore, final state is the correct answer. Then next question. Finite automaton is used in patterns, text editors, compiler construction. In all, these are all the applications of finite automata. So used in all these patterns, text editors, compiler construction. Therefore, answer is all. Then coming to next question. This is the last question. Here you can see progress. It is showing 30 by 30. The variable which produces an epsilon is called as a variable which produces an epsilon. That means null. Empty variable, nullable, terminal, all them above. So this is called as nullable only. Now you can click on finish test. So if you want to review the questions also here, you can so you can review all the questions by clicking back, etc. So if you want to review before submission, if any answer is wrong or if you have any doubt. So now after reviewing all questions, then what you have to do, you have to click on finish test. Now here you can see, so my review is over, then you have to click on finish test. Now here you can see your progress is shown. So now here attempt, first attempt passed, so minimum 40% is required. Now all are correct, so 12 minutes time is required to complete this test. So correct, so I got 100%. So like that you will get. So now even at any time later also, you can review questions, you can see the answers, even after completion of the course also. So now, if you want to retake, if your score is less, or if you want to get 100%, so again, you can retake test. In number of times, you can retake, not an issue. There is no restriction. Then click on continue. So after click on continue, it will ask to provide star rating. Here you can see it is showing, initially all are blank stars. So as per your experience, so you can provide your rating. So here it shows the star. Suppose if you can provide 5-star, that is a full rating. So then any feedback about this course, your experience, so you can write down. Suppose here I am writing, so very impressive and useful course, whatever the comment. So you can write with your understanding level. So with your experience, provide the star rating and comment. Why? Because this will useful as to improve ours. So based on your inputs. So then click on save and continue. Now it will ask some questions, basic questions. So are you learning valuable information? As for your answer, you can write. Suppose your my knowledge, yes. Are the explanations of concepts are clear? Yes. You can, by listening the videos, you can answer. Is the instructor's delivery engaging? Suppose yes. So are there enough opportunity to apply what you are learning? Okay, yes. Is the course delivering on your expectations? Yes or no? So you can mention your answer. Is the instructor knowledgeable about this topic? You can mention your answers. So then click on save and continue. So don't forget to give rating, feedback, and answers to these questions. Why? Because this will be useful for us to improve. So then, if you want to share this course to any of your friends, you can click on share on this link, then save and exit. So then, now congrats on finishing up this course. Then click on find more courses. So if any other courses are there. Now, here you can see your rating is showing. So now, if you want to get the certificate, again, you have to click on the course. Now, here you can see, now the progress is now changed to the cup color is changed to green 100%. Now here one option is there, get certificate. So immediately here you can see. So whenever you can complete the total 53 sections out of 53 are completed. So then only you will get the certificate. Now here click on get certificate. Now you can see your certificate is being downloaded now. Here you can see. Now here you can see, this is your certificate. This is to certify that this is the applicant name. So your name. So that's why you can give your name clearly as for your certificate. So in our educational qualification certificate, same name will appear. So your name successfully completed 31.5 total hours of formal language and automata theory online course on. So today is May 11th, for example. So today's date is displayed. So this is the course. So these are bottom, you can see certificate number, URL also there. So this you can put in our resume also. 31 hours duration means this is the valuable course. So internationally recognizable. So through Udemy platform. So now here, if you want to download certificate, here option is there. Even if you want to share the certificate, now here download option, here you can see two options are there. JPEG image format, PDF format. So whatever the format if you want. So now that format certificate is downloaded. Now here you can click on save image. So wherever the location, save with your name followed by course name. So now like that, you can complete the course. Now see how simply you have completed. So immediately you got the certificate. So like that, all of you complete this course and get the certificate immediately. Put the certificate on your status and share to your friends wherever it is required. So show your credentials. So you obtain the certificate like this. So later you can go to the course. You can learn lectures whenever you want. Okay, like this, all of you complete the course and provide your valuable star rating and feedback. Okay, in this now, I'm closing. So all the best for all of you. Happy learning.